We are taking RD Sharma Solutions Class 11, Chapter 12, Mathematical Induction Exercises 12.1. The first question is, if Pn is a statement, nn plus 1 is even, then we have to show what is P3. So just put 3 here in place of n, you get 3 into 3 plus 1, and this is what? 3 into 4, 12, which is an even number. Next is, if Pn is n cube plus n, which is divisible by 3, we have to prove that P3 is true, but P4 is untrue, not true. So just put 3 here, 3 is a 9, 9 3 is a 27, 27 plus 3 is 30, 30 is divisible by 3. So it is true. Now coming to 4, now put 4 here. So 4 cube, that is 64, 64 plus 3 is 67. Now 67 is not divisible by 3. So P4 is untrue, not true. If Pn is the statement, 2 to the power n is greater than or equal to 3n, if Pr is true, we have to prove that Pr plus 1 is also true. So let us assume that Pr is true. Pr is true, that means 2 to the power r is greater than or equal to 3r. Now multiply both sides by 2. So what do we get? Here we get the power adds 2 to the power r plus 1, and here we get 6r. Now 6r can be written as 3r plus 3r, but if you see 3r will always be greater than or equal to 3, put r1 here. So 3 is greater than or equal to 3, put 2 here. 3 into 2, 6 is always greater than or equal to 3. So here we can write it this just as 3. So this can be written as 2 to the power r plus 1 greater than or equal to 3r plus 3. So what do you get? 3 take common, r plus 1. And what is this? This is nothing but, this is pr plus 1. This is r plus 1, this is r plus 1, right? So if pr is true, pr plus 1 is also true. Now pn is n square plus n is even. So if pr is true, then pr plus 1 is also true. This we have to prove. So even numbers means, even we always show by 2, say lambda. Odd always we show like this, 2 lambda plus 1. So for an even number, we just say 2 lambda, 2k, like this. So if r square plus r, if we say that pr is true, just put r here. So r square plus r, if it is even, that it is equal to some 2 lambda. That is multiple of 2. Now for r plus 1, put r plus 1 in place of n. You get r plus 1 whole square plus r plus 1. Now expand it. This is r square plus 2r plus 1, and this is r plus 1. So what do you get? This r square plus r, this one, and 2r plus this 2. Now r square plus r can be written as 2 lambda. So put 2 lambda here. So what do you get? 2 lambda plus 2r plus 2. Now take 2 common. You get lambda plus r plus 1. Now this is again a constant. So you can put it like some mu. So 2 mu. Now anything which is 2 mu, that is, this is a multiple of 2. So it is even. So if pr is true, pr plus 1 is also true. This is proved. Give an example of a statement Pn such that it is true for all n belongs to n. So here is an example. 1, 2, 3 till n natural number, the sum is nn plus 1 by 2. You can check it for any number. Next is, if Pn is the statement, n square minus n plus 41 is a prime. We have to prove that P1, P2, P3, these are true, but P41 is untrue. So you just have to put the value. Put 1. It comes 41, it is true. It is a prime. Prime number is those numbers which are divisible by 1 or themselves. No other number can divide them. You put 2, you get 43, which is a prime. You put 3, you get 47, which is a prime. But if you put 41, you get 41 square. So what does this 41 square means? This is a prime. So P41 is not true, because this is not a prime. This is not a prime. Anything which is square is never a prime. So this is the exercise 12.1 of Mathematical Induction, RD Sharma.